Let's see how much does it cost a setup for EAA astrophotography with a Dobsonian telescope for beginners. I will show you my setup, which is what I recommend, and also some alternatives you can use at a lower cost. I will exclude though certain accessories you can buy later, but they are not needed to start doing EAA astrophotography with a Dobsonian telescope. My choice is the 8-inch classic Dobsonian. This is the premium version, which I recommend. It costs at this moment around $600. And this premium version has a difference in the altitude bearings and also the double speed focuser. The simple classic version is a bit cheaper, but it doesn't have this focuser, which makes a huge difference. And the difference in price is not so big. Although it has a modern system of the altitude bearings here, in my opinion, it doesn't add such an improvement. This is the GSO brand, rebranded by Telescope Service Optics from Germany, but there are many other brands with the same GSO product. The Skywatcher simple classic version has another system that you probably know, with the altitude bearings. And between those three systems, the one Skywatcher use, this modern one, and the spring system, like my 12-inch Dobsonian has, it's a personal choice, but I prefer the old system with the springs. It's easier to manage and to balance. About the aperture, I chose the 8-inch because it's more versatile. It fits all the needs, especially about the portability. It's much more portable than the 12-inch. So for this beginner setup, this is my choice. Another characteristic for you to decide when buying the 8-inch Dobsonian telescope is if you want with push-to, with go-to, or without go-to. My choice is without go-to. It's cheaper, and I will have later the equatorial platform in order to get the tracking. The thing is, I only recommend the go-to telescope if you can't see almost no stars due to the light pollution you have in your observing site. Otherwise, I would choose an equatorial platform with a classic Dobsonian telescope. And about the push-to system, for me even worse, because it doesn't deliver you a tracking system. You will not track the sky with a push-to, and only it will help you if you don't see stars in the sky. Otherwise, if you see stars in the sky, you will learn much more and have much more fun searching and do star hopping. A telrad is an instrument which I strongly recommend for your Dobsonian telescope, any of them. It's so important for me that I will add it to this beginner setup. And now that we have already our 8-inch Dobsonian telescope, we will need a tracking. For that, we will use an equatorial platform. If you decided to buy a go-to telescope, you will not need the equatorial platform. However, remember that an equatorial platform can be used with other telescopes. The go-to of your telescope, it's only for that telescope. And to buy an equatorial platform, it will depend where you live. In the United States, you have a market. In Europe, you have another market, and there are loads of differences. My choice is the Geoptic platform. It's Italian and it costs around $1,000. There are more expensive ones and there are cheaper ones. You can find cheaper ones around $400. However, I strongly recommend you, if you buy one of those, that you buy to a reliable vendor, so you can return it if it doesn't match your telescope. And now that we have already the 8-inch telescope and an equatorial platform, we can track the sky and watch visually the objects without they running away from the field of view of the eyepiece, and we are happy with it. However, we start thinking about taking some photos and we want to do EAA or astrophotography. So for that, of course, we need a camera. The cheaper choice, which I don't recommend at all, is to use your smartphone. Okay, you have it on your pocket, you use it. But just think in another solution for the future. It isn't worth it, believe me. You can take two or three decent pictures, but that's it. You can also use, if you have at home, a DSLR camera. But if you are going to buy, I recommend to buy an astro camera, a dedicated camera for astrophotography. There are different brands. What matters more is the chip size. The larger the chip, usually the most expensive it will be the camera. For instance, I started with a 224, which is a small chip, and I ended with a 294, which is a larger chip. And within those sizes, there are loads of different models. I will choose for this setup the cheaper one, the 224. Being a small sensor, you can use it for planets, for the moon, for galaxies, for planetary nebulae, for most of the interesting objects in the sky. And as a reference, you can use it in an Orion nebula, but it will cut the edges. However, with a simple trick, buying a focal reducer with 50 bucks, you can increase a bit the 224 sensor without getting aberrations at the edges of the field, just placing a cheap 2-inch focal reducer near the sensor. That will make the trick. And for this camera, you will absolutely need a UV IR cut filter. I use the Bader, but you can buy a cheap one by 20 bucks. Of course, there's something still needed, which is a device, usually a laptop, but you can use any device, including a smartphone. And I will assume that you already have a laptop or at least a smartphone. So this is my recommended total investment for a Dobsonian EAA Astrophotography Starter Kit. If you already own a Dobsonian telescope, the investment, of course, will be smaller. For smartphone users, stay tuned because I will show in a video how to use a smartphone with an astro camera and your Dobsonian telescope, which is my favorite telescope for beginners by many reasons, like these 5 reasons to buy an 8-inch Dobsonian telescope, which I recommend you to watch right away.